Anduril's counter-drone systems have received a significant endorsement from the Pentagon with an order worth hundreds of millions of dollars for additional units. This marks a major victory for Anduril, a relative newcomer in the defense industry whose rapidly expanding product lineup is focused on disrupting the established market. Anduril stated in an announcement, "Anduril Industries has been awarded a $249,978,466 contract to deliver advanced air defense capabilities across services for the Department of Defense. This contract will deliver more than 500 Roadrunner-Ms and additional Pulsar electronic warfare capabilities, addressing the growing threat of unmanned aerial systems (UAS) attacks against U.S. forces. Deliveries will begin in the fourth quarter of 2024 and continue through the end of 2025. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how Anduril's Roadrunner-M and Pulsar could help the U.S. military counter unmanned threats. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The proliferation of cheap drones has changed the dynamics of the modern battlefield. American forces in the Red Sea and Gulf of Aden have been shooting down Houthi one-way attack drones and missiles fired from Yemen. The cost of those interceptions was too high. According to the Pentagon's chief of weapons procurement, efforts to take out uncrewed aerial systems were exceeding $100,000 per shot. William LaPlante, the Undersecretary of Defense for Acquisition and Sustainment at the Department of Defense, noted at a conference hosted by the Center for Strategic and International Studies that efforts to stop drones fired by Houthi militants in Yemen are relying on costly missiles fired from Navy destroyers or fighter jets. He said it's getting too expensive. For example, Standard Missile 2, a medium-range surface-to-air missile, can cost $2.1 million per shot. The issue further came into focus when U.S. forces joined Israel and other partners in helping shoot down approximately 300 one-way attack UAVs and missiles fired from Iran and its partners toward Israel. On that occasion, several F-15E fighter jets firing air-to-air missiles, Patriot air defense batteries, and Aegis combat system-equipped warships worked in tandem with Israeli systems like Arrow, David Sling, and Iron Dome to thwart the onslaught, but that came at a very high price. This is where Roadrunner and Pulsar come in. Anduril's Roadrunner system, a high-explosive vertical takeoff and landing (VTOL) interceptor introduced last year, features exceptional maneuverability enabled by its vectored thrust turbojets. The Roadrunner is capable of neutralizing a variety of threats, including drones, cruise missiles, and even low-flying manned aircraft. Depending on its configuration, it can also be deployed for surveying and striking ground targets or be equipped with non-kinetic payloads. Palmer Lucky, founder of Anduril Industries, said when introducing the Roadrunner, "It's somewhere between a reusable missile and a full-scale autonomous aircraft. Roadrunner itself is a totally reusable aircraft, and there's a lot of payloads you can put on it where it's totally reusable." The launch system for Roadrunner is a self-contained box-like hangar, also called a nest. As per Lucky, the hangar has a significant amount of built-in functionality, including the ability to conduct continuous monitoring of all the systems, health monitoring, health feedback, a variety of maintenance functions, and a variety of environmental control functions. Because it's networked, Roadrunner units housed in nest launcher boxes can be spread across a wide area to enhance response time and protection coverage. However, the system is designed so that a single operator can launch, manage, and recover multiple vehicles independently. If it returns in one piece from a sortie, it lands vertically on four flip-down outriggers at the base of its body, similar to the SpaceX Falcon 9 space launch rocket booster. Roadrunner can be quickly refueled and sent back out if needed. It could be extremely useful aboard ships that have become targets for drone attacks. While little information is available regarding Roadrunner-M, it seems to have enhanced performance when compared to the original system. Pulsar is a family of software-defined electromagnetic warfare, or EW, systems that leverages AI to rapidly adapt to emerging threats. The capabilities include electronic countermeasures, advanced EW, and counter-unmanned systems. It can jam devices like drones, provide geolocation services, and facilitate communication. The AI comes into play once the technology detects new threats in the electromagnetic spectrum, accelerating the response timeline by delivering a tailored defense within hours or days, which can be propagated to the entire Pulsar family. Pulsar, in a fixed configuration, offers 360-degree or directional detection and denial and enables customized coverage for the conditions and environment. Multiple Pulsars can be networked together to provide adaptable and comprehensive coverage based on scenarios and mission requirements. Pulsar's modular form factor can be adapted and integrated into ground vehicles, Pulsar V, or aircraft, Pulsar A, to support multiple EW mission sets. This order is not unexpected, given the Pentagon's ongoing challenge in addressing the growing threat from lower-end drones and long-range one-way attack munitions. In a press release, Anduril stated that Roadrunner has been operationally deployed for combat evaluation since January 2024, and Pulsar has been operationally deployed in multiple regions since August 2023. In other words, Roadrunner and Pulsar have already been deployed in the field for evaluation, which seems to have been successful. Previous smaller contracts for these systems likely supported limited deployments, leading to this larger order. This new contract is approximately 2.5 times the size of the DoD's previous investments in both systems. Notably, Anduril's Lattice Open Architecture Autonomy Command and Control software is compatible with both systems. Given the importance of these capabilities in future conflicts, if Roadrunner and Pulsar continue to prove effective and evolve, these orders could increase significantly.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.